If you've ever dipped your toes into sea, you know it's like petting a wild animal. Exciting, a bit dangerous, and you might lose a finger if you're not careful. Sea is powerful, but writing safe code in it can feel like playing a high-stakes game of will it crash. So why is C unsafe? Why do we have to wrestle with unsafe functions like we're in a cage match, while other languages just sail by without all this drama? Let's dive in and find out. Now, just like C makes you question your code choices, there's a much better way to sharpen your skills safely and effectively. That's where today's sponsor Brilliant.org comes in. Brilliant is where you can learn complex topics like programming, data analysis, and even AI without having to worry about crashing the whole system. With Brilliant, you're not just passively learning, it's a full-on training ground for building real skills. Take their programming courses for example. You'll start coding with real-world applications from day one, building problem-solving skills that are critical whether you're coding in C, Python, or learning data science. They even have a mobile app so you can learn whenever you've got a moment to spare, whether it's diving deep into algorithms or playing with concepts in creative coding. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, scan the QR code on screen or you can click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. So what are you waiting for? So where were we left? Right, C and casts. Imagine if you could transform into anyone just by putting on a pair of glasses. Well, that's what casting is like in C. In type-safe languages like Java or Python, the system constantly checks to make sure your variables behave as expected. You can't just tell the compiler, trust me bro, but in C, just cast away. In C, any type can be reinterpreted as any other type with a simple cast. Wanna treat an integer as a string? Go ahead. Want to treat a pointer to a character as a double? Knock yourself out. But here's the catch. Unlike Java or Python, C isn't double checking that everything makes sense. It's more like, I'll do my best, but if it blows up, that's on you. And that's exactly where things get interesting. A classic exploit here involves writing malicious code into memory, then casting it to something that tricks the programming into running it. You could end up with anything from your app mysteriously crashing to accidentally building the next Skynet. Let's hope it's just the former. Now let's talk arrays. In most languages, arrays have boundaries, like walls around the garden. Try to go beyond these walls, and the language will politely stop you. But not in C. Here arrays are a bit like the open wilderness, no fences and no guardrails. C doesn't have automatic array bounds checking. This means yes, you can run straight off the edge of an array and not even realize it until things go kaboom. And that's not even the scariest part. With locally allocated arrays, you're walking around with a loaded cannon. Accidentally override the return address, that's the spot in memory that says where to go next, and boom, you've turned your program into a random action generator. A lot of C security holes come from buffer overruns. That's when a program writes outside the bounds of an array. It's like renting a storage locker and then accidentally stuffing your stuff into someone else's. When the return address gets overwritten, the program may jump to who knows where and start running garbage code. So in the end, C's no guardrails approach is powerful but comes with serious responsibility. You can do whatever you want, but you're one unguarded line away from disaster. Want to avoid it? It's all about vigilance, careful coding, and a healthy amount of paranoia.